American lawyers like to say our justice system is the fairest in the world. If that's true, I pity the rest of the world. Because in America, a small, powerful group of Washington overlords, federal prosecutors, sometimes break rules to win cases, often wrecking the lives of people who did nothing wrong. You can read about this in this new book by Sidney Powell, License to Lie, Exposing Corruption in the Department of Justice. She writes that overzealous, ambitious, narcissistic, and dishonest prosecutors destroy innocent people by deliberately withholding evidence, evidence they knew contradicted their cases. For example, remember the Arthur Anderson accounting firm? 80,000 people worked there. But they lost their jobs after the government claimed Anderson Partners helped Enron commit accounting fraud. The prosecutors claimed the employees destroyed evidence once they saw the government was coming to investigate.
Anderson shipped off nearly 2 tons of documents for shredding. A year later, the Justice Department won a conviction against Anderson for obstruction of justice, and the company was ruined.
It was. The whole company. Instead of charging the individuals who allegedly destroyed evidence, but that might have taken more time, more trials, that might have gotten less publicity, they instead indicted the whole company. And once indicted, Anderson lost most of its clients. Publicly traded companies aren't even allowed to do business with a company under criminal investigation. So Anderson went out of business. The prosecutor's purpose, says Powell, was to chill resistance from any other company that might dare resist the feds. Cooperate or we will destroy you. And this was necessary, they said, because shredding documents is a crime that attacks the justice system itself by impeding discovery of the truth. Well, maybe. But who actually hid the truth? The prosecutors, writes Powell. Despite the prosecutors' claims about shredded documents and obstruction of justice, Anderson had, in fact, saved its documents and produced them to the government. Powell says the prosecutors simply lied. Once that was revealed,
the Supreme Court overturned that conviction.
Too late, 80,000 people lost their jobs. So were the prosecutors then jailed, or at least punished, disbarred? No, the overlords protect their own. Believe it or not, they were promoted. Next, they accused 4 Merrill Lynch executives of fraud for falsifying Enron's books. The government lawyers told the media that Enron conspired with Wall Street bankers to carry out a sham transaction. 4 Merrill Lynch executives got jail sentences, 3 to 4 years. Powell writes that the government never alleged anything that actually constituted a crime by Merrill Lynch execs. Instead, it cobbled together parts of different statutes to make up some new kind of new crime that didn't even make sense. And sure enough, an appeals court tossed most of the verdict, and the Merrill executives were released. But that was after they'd spent a year in jail. That led Paul Kammerall of the Washington Legal Foundation to say this.
We hope that this decision will send a strong message to the Justice Department to stop this kind of abusive prosecutorial misconduct.
You would hope, but it didn't. The prosecutors next went after Republican Senator Ted Stevens of Alaska.
Today, it all came crashing down for Senator Ted Stevens.
The federal jury here in Washington found United States Senator Ted Stevens of Alaska guilty on all counts. 7 felony counts of making false statements. Senator Stevens accepted gifts.
Senator Stevens, said the prosecutors, got $250,000 in gifts from rich donors and never reported that.
I really believe that I have not done anything is wrong.
And it turns out that he may not have done anything wrong. For example, he did not get $250,000 in gifts.
When an explosive report today detailing alleged misconduct by the Justice Department in the corruption case against the late Alaska Senator Ted Stevens. The report is alleging that federal prosecutors knowingly withheld evidence.
There was clear and intentional misconduct by prosecutors in that case.
The Justice Department's own review found the prosecutors had hidden evidence, and a witness lied under oath. A judge threw out that conviction, too. So were the prosecutors then punished for their misdeeds? No. The lead Stevens prosecutor, Matthew Friedrich, left for a higher-paying job at a private law firm. The director of the Enron task force, Leslie Caldwell, became an assistant attorney general at the Justice Department. Andrew Weissman, who helped prosecute the Anderson accounting firm and Merrill Lynch employees, was made deputy director of the FBI. And Merrill prosecutor Catherine Rumler was promoted to deputy attorney general, then promoted again to White House counsel. And now it's reported that she's President Obama's first choice to replace Eric Holder to become America's next attorney general. They were rewarded for abusing their power. Government prosecutors always have an advantage anyway. They have endless time and almost endless money. If they sue you, you have to stop your life and spend probably all your savings on lawyers. You never know when their attack might end, and if you did fight all the way to trial, you still might lose. So most everyone settles, even those who think they're innocent. Unless you're very rich, you can't afford to fight the feds. If they want you, they'll probably get you. And then they may get promoted, even if they lie. We invited prosecutors Friedrich, Caldwell, Weissman, and Rumler to reply to the charges laid out in Powell's book, but they did not respond.